I call it my cancer marathon because it has just been a long, continuous cancer journey that has lasted over 22 years. My first cancer diagnosis came in the fall of 1994. I was 30 years old, a wife, a mom, working full time. So I've had it all. Chemo, radiation, surgery, a bilateral mastectomy. I had to have my eye removed and a stem cell transplant. So I have had longer remissions that have gotten shorter and shorter. Ian, we are relatively newlyweds. I had my first relapse a year after we had started dating. Cancer has involved our entire relationship. So when I got this last diagnosis of lymphoma, it was clear that the standard of care was no longer an option for me. The navigator that was available to me to help me look through clinical trials said, "Would you consider a CAR-T trial?" It's so new that even my local oncologist last year, he wasn't aware. I honestly wrote to every single doctor that was leading a trial all over the United States. CAR-T, when I first heard about it, sounded incredible, but yet so sci-fi, like this is how we're gonna treat cancer someday. And I was surprised that like that someday was here.
It's your own body doing the healing, and they're only helping your cells. They're just giving them a homing signal to go after the cell they should be going after in the first place.
I entered the CAR-T trial at Mass General Hospital in Boston. I received 3 days of chemotherapy, very low dose, and the purpose of that was to clear out the existing T cells that I had so that there would be room for my new supercharged, awesome T cells. 2 days later, I was admitted to the hospital to receive the dose. The first sign that the CAR-T was working was actually on day 3. My side effects were pretty much the fever. I was a little bit achy. I think I had my blood pressure drop. And then I had severe pain in the area that the tumor was at. That was kind of exciting because the doctor said, that's the CAR-T is going to work on your tumor. For me, immunotherapy was dramatically different than any other treatment that I'd had. I liked it because I felt like it was working with my body instead of against it.
In a few weeks after the treatment, we're walking Boston. We got the job done. Now let's go enjoy ourselves.
So my CAR-T treatment was received last year. And then in October, I had a relapse. Knowing of some of the things in my life that would be coming up, like my daughter getting married, you know, it was hard to think that maybe I wouldn't be here for those things. So I felt desperate, like I've got to get that other CAR-T because I know it worked for me the first time. And when they did the PET scan, there was no lymphoma anywhere. They feel that somehow the CAR-T got re-energized. I was back in remission. In my history of cancer treatments, I've had to be really persistent to stay in the game. Cancer Research Institute is doing the same thing. And I'm so appreciative of the effort to get this way of treatment available to people. Because without that immunotherapy, like I wouldn't be here today.
Now that we're coming up on a year, and I see how Jami has responded, it's like we have a new life to start over.
And we finally took our honeymoon. Now planning my daughter's wedding, and now I can't stop thinking about grandchildren, and we just have so much to look forward to now, and I really think I'm gonna be here for all of it. I'm looking forward to a 50th wedding anniversary. Yeah. I mean, that would make me over 100, but I think we can do it.
I think we can do it.
We can do it, yeah.